Hello everyone. Now the arithmetic progressions exercise 1.3 question number 19. What the question number 19 is here? 200 logs are stacked in the following manner. 20 logs in the bottom row, 19 in the next and 18 in the next row next to it and so on. In how many rows are the 20 logs placed and how many logs are there in the topper row? So we need to find here the two things. First of all, how many rows means we have to find n, and how many logs are there in the top row means it is nothing but the last term. We have to find the last term as well as we have to find the n here. We will see first of all what the question is. It is given 20 logs are there in bottom row. In the bottom it has given 20 logs like this. It has 20 logs are there, on that one less, so it is having 19. So it can be written here as the first log is 20, the second will be 19, and the next will be 18, next will be 17, and so on. Like this they are placing the logs. So to place the 200 logs, how many rows will be there? So what we have to find? First we need to find the n here. After getting the n value, we have to find the last term. These are nothing but the given sequence. These are the sequence of the term. The downside is having 20 logs, and what will be the topmost row will have the number of logs. Let's see the solution here stepwise. N we have to find. We have to find the last number. A is given as 20. The difference. Difference is nothing but A2 minus A1. 19 minus 20 is minus 1. The sum is given as 200. If we'll substitute here in the SN formula, 200 is equals to N by 2. A is 20. N minus 1 into minus 1. These 2 is in denominator. When we are shifting, it comes to numerator. 200 into 2. Then 2 into 20, 40. Minus 1 we will multiply means minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. Now again 200 into 2, 400. 40 plus 1, 41. If we will multiply 41 into n, n into n is n square. This minus n square, when we are shifting, it will become plus n square. It is plus means it will becoming as minus 41. 400 as it is, because we are not changing the position of 400. If you'll see here carefully, this is nothing but a quadratic equation. When we are having a quadratic equation, we can find its root by the factorizing it by taking sum and product. The sum is here minus 41n, and the product is the first and last. 400 into n square is 400 n square. So we have to select the two numbers so that their sum is minus 41 and their product is 400. So the two numbers will be minus 25n and minus 16n. At the place of minus 41, we are taking minus 25n minus 16n. Starting two terms are having n as common, so it is remaining n minus 25. Next two are having 16 as common, because 400 can be written as 16 into 25. So n is common, minus 25. So two roots you are getting here, n minus 25, n minus 16. So n minus 25 will be equals to 0, as well as n minus 16 will be equals to 0. N values are nothing but 25 and 16. Why we are not considering this n as 25? Because it is given clearly that it is having 20 logs at the beginning, and when the 20 logs are there means the maximum number of rows will be 20 only. It will be 20, 19, 18, up to 1 you can get that for 20 rows only. When you are taking n as 25, it is becoming more than 20. That's why it cannot be the answer. Our answer will be n is equals to 16. So like this, 16 rows are there to form the 200 logs. And one more thing we have to find in this as the last term. Now we will find the last term. SN is equals to n by 2a plus l. Here the sum is given as 200, n is 16 by 2, a is 20. 2 1s are 2 8s are gets cancelled, so it is becoming 8. Now 8 is in multiplication, when we'll shift it comes to division. 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 4 will remain, 8 5s are 40. So you are getting here as 25. Plus 20 when we are shifting, it will be coming minus 20. 25 minus 20 is equals to L. So the last term, the last row will have the 5 logs. What it means here in this question, at the beginning, if it is having the 20 logs and if we are reducing 1 after 15, if you are taking here as after 20, it will be like 19, it will be like 18, 17. If you are reducing like this, it will come till up to 5. So where we are getting here the 5 logs, they will become as the sum equal to 200. Hope you have understood this question. If you are having any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you.